Equity and Justice, American Women Composing in the Emerging 20th Century, explores women's voices in the years surrounding women's suffrage. Our concert pairs vocal and piano selections reflecting the diverse socio-cultural aspects of 20th century women's voices.
We begin with women's voices before suffrage, when they were marginalized, but nevertheless, they found ways to impact socio-political issues with parlor music and folk ballads. Ragtime composer Adaline Shepherd couldn't vote, but she did create Pickles and Peppers Rag for William Jennings Bryan's campaign song.
The folk ballads of folk song collector and composer Jean Ritchie, 1922 to 2015, revisits the truths that were taught to our foremothers through traditional song, brought to America from her British Island ancestors. One of the most recognized, Barbara Ellen, tells the tale of a young woman who refuses to succumb to the control of her philandering beau.
So slowly, slowly she can't get Barbie Ellen. Don't you recall in yonder's town, in yonder's town, a drinking? You passed your glass to all the girls around, but you slide.
Women's voices of social protest emerged in their music after the 19th Amendment, which finally franchised them to vote. Ruth Crawford, 1901 to 1953, archived Appalachian Mountain songs at the Smithsonian, which brought joy to children struggling with the devastation of poverty. Her sixth piano prelude, Andante Mistico, composed in the modernist style of dissonant serialism, offers an evocative reflection of the economic depression after World War I. Thank you.
Jean Ritchie's composition, West Virginia Mine Disaster, is a poignant reflection of the devastating effect that unregulated mining had on the people of the Appalachian Mountains in the mid-20th century.
Say, did you see him going? It was early this morning. He passed by your houses on the way to the coal. He was tall, he was slender, and his dark eyes so tender. His occupation was mining, West Virginia, his home. It was just before 12 I was feeding the children. Ben Mosley came running to tell us the news. Number 8 is all flooded, many men are in danger, and we don't know their number, but we fear they're all doomed. So I picked up the baby and I left all the others to comfort each other and pray for our own. There's Timmy, 14, and there's John, not much younger. Their time soon will be coming to go down the black hole. Oh, if I had the money to do more than just feed them, I'd give them good learning, the best could be found. Then when they grow up, there'd be checkers and weighers, and not spend their life drilling in a hole underground. Now what can I say to his poor little children? And what can I tell his old mother at home? And what can I say to my heart that's clear broken? To my heart that's clear broken, if my darling is gone. Say, did you see him going? It was early this morning. He passed by your houses on the way to the coal. He was tall, he was slender, and his dark eyes so tender. His occupation was mining, West Virginia, his home.
Women's Voices Resolving Racism are presented in the music of Margaret Bonds, 1913-72, who wrote, "I realized very young that I was the link between Negro composers of the past. If I deserve any credit, it's that I've stuck to my own ethnic material and worked to develop it." Her piano rhapsody, Troubled Water, memorializes abolitionist Harriet Tubman, aka Moses, who helped slaves escape on the Underground Railroad. Thank you.
bonds, he's got the whole world in his hand, ends our program, affirming our common bonds of humanity. Whether we are women or men, whether we are of Native American, African, European, or Asian descent, bonds that unite us all, and bonds that give us power, dignity, and equality through our cultural heritage and through our music.
The whole world in his hand. He's got 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 the woods and the waters in his hand. He's got the woods and the waters in his hand. He's got the sun and the moon right in his hand. He's got the whole world in his hand. He's got the birds and the bees right in his hand. He's got the birds and the bees right in his hand.